position next. 33 screen stocks at last call. 33 screen stocks at last count. We'll definitely be having counts in our screen stocks tonight.
How
about
like having half goes there?
Erase four. Erase four. You sound like the Kool-Aid man there. That was kind of like the Kool-Aid macho man together.
She took a nasty moment with her. Good to see her out back on the double O.
Another car we haven't seen much of this year right behind us, a 78 from Corona. That is Nick Lawrence. It's Nick Lawrence with a 78 in front of us from Corona, Illinois. 23 car Keep your eye on this guy from Coal City, Illinois. Many feature wins by your rear is stuff. That is Tony Club. Tony Club in the 23. Keep your eye on him. Right behind Tony. Ford Z from Kingston. And Zach Zubereyer picked up your feature win last night up at Pocono. Man, we got some heavy hitters coming off this one. Some cars out here. We got some street stock planned in here. The 95 car, Jesse Owen, obviously right here from one for this weekly, always a quick car on the 95, the 41 car. Picked up the feature win, I believe it is only one start this year that's got a feature win here. As Kyle Anderson comes with Crown Point, Indiana. The 57 with a feature win this year. That is Ben Hamer right behind Ben. The G51 from Indiana. Thank you. Adams is where did that Dodge. The Dodge.
I'll tell you what. I went out to Macon Speedway a couple years ago and I watched this guy come out. He raced in their B mod class. I believe he won the B mod, had an interview with Victory Circle, and pulled off, got restrapped back in, and he pulled around to the tail of the field for the A mod feature, and then proceeded in his B mod to drive through the field and get third in the A mod feature with a Mopar motor under the hood.
Yes, you can take Macon and put it inside where our infield is. If you've never talked about Macon, if you've never been to Macon, you have to make the trip to Macon once. They have their big race every year. Your old D100 apartment.
Don't drop chips.
Yeah, we'll count other racetracks. We've got to keep the sport alive. Macon, went down every year. I go there every year for that race. Always a good time at Macon Speedway. You want to see bull ring action? That's a bull ring action.
It's what makes Illinois famous, man. Them bull rings, baby.
I do believe the Herald Review 100 is the, it's either that or the Illinois State Championship Pure or the longest running, the last longest running race. I think the Herald Review goes back to the 30s. All right, Sport Compacts coming out. 18 Sport Compacts with us tonight. That's good to see.
It's gonna be a good race for these folks.
Racing for a duel.
See all sorts of walks of life roll out here. Gonna see some Hondas, gonna see some Dodge Neons, I'm sure. Gonna see some Cobalts, see some Nissans.
Looks like that's a new car for Josh, or do you paint it for Josh McIntyre?
Oh, we just painted it, hashtag no money racing.
All right. Not familiar with a lot of these guys, new cars here with this nice show. I have to do the old scrolling here, but I have to scroll these buttons. Different cars to identify, guys. The zero car that is Rick Zipko, quick Rick Zipko for him. Keep your eye on that car. That car is always fast, but your ones was fast the one time. We were 7X to Rob Harding Jr. from Clinton, right behind the 13 of Lucas Pappas out of Milan, Illinois. 9 a.m. on our locals here in Noble Morrow. Right behind him, the 40 of that car. The Harding and Jacob Walter from Farley, Iowa. 22 cars.
Thank you.
21-22. As they just keep going, which the reset of the first 21 modifieds. clear two for your modifieds. Matt Warner, 15.052. Second, 15.175 for Mitch Morris. And Scott Lemke, the new mini runner, with a 16.253. We got so much to give away tonight. Candy. You know, I just bought stock in the every quad city dentist, I bought stock in tonight with candies.
I don't get to take this candy home with me, Mike. Somebody has got some explaining to do. I thought this was just for me. I thought it was my thank you. My people love me. It's like the opera singer getting all the roses at the end of the show, my friend. Come on.
Please don't do this again. Just no.
All right, I don't think we got any more hot laps underway, so we'll check and wait and see here. Maybe I'm wrong. There's some motors rumbling back there. If not, we'll wait and see if we get the truck pulling up.
I'm still kind of young. It'll be all right.
Don't forget, we'll just be our last night tonight. If you have a chance, come out and see the photo booth, Jensen Photography. Nick's got some great photos down there. Jensen Racing photos. Go down, get yourself 1, 2, 5, 10. They make nice little things. Put them in your garage.
They're honestly super.
Yes.
He does not charge much. He does a lot of work. It's a lot of really cool things. Shout out to Jensen Photography
for anything
they've done all season.
Thanks,
Nick. Good job getting all the photos, buddy.
See, he stands right there. He's right there getting the photos right now.
Yeah, I'm jolly. He gets a good view. He gets a better view, I will say. He gets some of them shots. He gets some of them, views of the track that most people don't ever get to see.
In some of the positions he takes pictures from, we would never catch me dead in there. It's like, man, you got some on you.
I'd do it. I really would. What's up? How you doing? All right. Yes. I forgot we've had the double O's doing the flags. My apology, guys. Usually done by Gunez. We support us with the truck with the flags on the back, but it is, after all, the night of our fallen heroes, and then most importantly, the night of the Ronnie Weed Memorial here, as we are so honored to have it back here at East Moline Speedway. When Ron talked to me last week about it, guys, I got really shaky because that means a lot to me, this race, as many times around here. Here we go. We're going to please have you rise, remove your caps and hats, anything you got, and play and pay your respects to this great country.
True!
Street. You know what's awesome about tonight? We've had Dirty Mile all year long with Gary Webb. No Gary Webb tonight. But we have two Dirty Mile Hall of Famers tonight. Regus Jr. drafted the Nostalgia Car. And good old Cole Blue was also inducted into the Dirty Mile Hall of Fame down in Florence, Kentucky. If you've never made that trip, there's another trip you got to make someday. Check out the Dirt Late Model Hall of Fame in Florence, Kentucky, during the Northside 100. Always a great event.
Always on my bucket list. I'm telling you what, I'm here, nothing but great things.
The first time.